here?
My name is Raj Shah. I'm the administrator of the U.S. Agency for International Development. And I'm very excited to be able to be here today and to visit this very important refugee camp that is a major point of safety and security and humanitarian support for Syrian refugees. I want to start just by commending the government of Jordan. I'm here with Minister Jafar, who, of course, leads this effort on behalf of the government. It's Jordan's generosity and openness and commitment to humanitarian protection for Syrian displaced persons has made a tremendous difference, and we stand with the government of Jordan in that effort.
The presence of Dr. Shah, USAID administrator, here today only underlines the great support and importance USAID and the U.S. government attaches to enabling the Jordanian government and UN agencies to go ahead with this important role. There are more than 27,000 in this camp today, more than 150,000 living within Jordanian communities in different parts of the country, and it is very important for us to be able to continue in providing the basic humanitarian services that these people require.
The United States, President Obama, and Secretary Clinton have been very clear that we are calling on the Assad regime to end its brutal treatment and attacks on its own people. And President Obama has also asked us, the United States, to do everything we can to support the critical humanitarian needs that are in this region. That's why we've already provided more than $82 million of support for humanitarian priorities inside of Syria, reaching more than 700,000 Syrians with food, water, and medical support. And that's why today I'm quite pleased to announce an additional $21 million commitment. The $21 million will help ensure that the children and their families have adequate food and nutrition, especially as they prepare for the times ahead and the winter. The $21 million will also ensure greater access to food rations, dry ration packets inside Syria for the nearly 1.2 million displaced Syrians that are still inside of Syria. And these resources will provide support to other countries such as Turkey, where significant refugees, in that case 80,000, are going into the camps there, and where the World Food Program and other UN partners are doing everything they can to make sure that refugees receive services that help keep them alive and protect them. And we call on other partners all around the world to stand with the governments and people of Turkey and Jordan and other neighboring countries that have put a tremendous amount of energy, resources, access, and generosity into protecting and supporting the needs of Syrian refugees.